Hello and welcome to part 7 of the first of the 3 weekly lessons about Oracle Jet. Up until this part, we have covered a whole range of fundamental topics relating to Jet. We started with learning about require.js for modularity, knockout.js for data binding. We looked at setting up Oracle Jet components. We explored Oracle Jet modules. And in this part, we're going to look at the Oracle Jet command line interface. The Oracle Jet command line interface is a very useful tool that is easy to set up and very powerful to use. Here we are on the command line and we have installed the Oracle Jet command line interface. The first point to notice is that you can type ojet --help, which will provide documentation on each of the commands that the command line interface makes available. Add, build, clean, create, and so on. But what you can also do here is that you can get further help on each of these commands. So for example, if you want to find out more information about create, what we can do here is type ojet help, followed by the command about which we would like to have more information. So now I type ojet help create, and you see a range of examples. So here's how to create an application with the template navbar. Here is a topic that will be addressed later about Cordova and hybrid mobile development. Here you can see how to set up a new Jet application based on one of the examples, the Fixit Fast application. Here is how to add a CCA component, an Oracle Jet web component that we will talk about in the third lesson. And here is how to add a theme. In other words, whenever you would like to have more information about a particular command, type ojet help, followed by the command about which you would like to have some more information. And always, in each of those cases, you'll be provided with a list of examples, example command lines that you can use together with the command that you have asked for further help on. So we type ojet help, and then, for example, build. And you see now a list of example command lines that make use of the build command. At this point, you should also be very aware of the fact that whenever you use ojet serve, Oracle Jet will watch your application, and whenever you make changes, will automatically reload the changes that you have made into the browser. So you can see here, after ojet serve is called, that a message watching files is printed out to the terminal, signifying to you that Oracle Jet is watching for changes and will automatically reload them into the application. I can see my dashboard HTML file. I make a change here to, for example, hello world instead of dashboard content area. I click save. However, I do that via keyboard shortcut or the save action. And what I can now see in the terminal is that the Oracle Jet command line interface has picked up that this file was changed and that it has reloaded it automatically. So that in the browser, I automatically see my hello world message. By this point of the course, you should be aware of this functionality. You've been using it. Whenever you've saved a file, automatically a reload is done. You don't need to refresh the browser. Saves you a lot of time and is built into the Oracle Jet command line interface. Another feature that the command line interface provides is the strip command and the restore command. The strip command strips all non-source files from a Jet application, while the restore command restores those. You probably only want to check in your own source files into your source code repository, such as Git or via Subversion or via Mercurial. So what you should do before you check in is to say ojet and then strip, press enter, and then the node modules that were included before are no longer in the node modules folder. They have been removed. That folder is now empty. If we now try to serve up the application, we are told that various libraries are not available. That is because we have stripped the application and we have not restored it. Now, when you run ojet restore, within your application's root folder, all the JavaScript libraries that you have deleted are going to be re-added via the Oracle Jet command line interface. Now you can do the ojet serve or the ojet build again. Another important command to be aware of is the add command. When we type OJET help add, we see a range of different types of features that you can add to an existing application, such as support for Cordova. In other words, you can create a complete Oracle Jet web application and then later decide that you want to make it a hybrid Cordova-based application as well. And so you can type OJET add hybrid, which will add a hybrid folder. You can say add platform, iOS or Android or Windows, and that particular platform will be added into the application. You can add plugins for Cordova into the application. And these are all topics we will look at later. And in addition, you can add support for SES, the super awesome stylesheet language, to an existing application as well. So also be aware of the various features you can add to an existing application. In the context of the Oracle Jet command line interface, it is also very useful to know that NetBeans has built into it support for a terminal window. Go to the Tools menu and then choose Open in Terminal while having the project selected that you want to work with. So here we have selected a particular project. We go to Tools, Open in Terminal, and then that folder opens inside of the NetBeans terminal window, at which point you can call any terminal command directly inside NetBeans. So for example, ls to see the content of the application, and also commands like OJET build. In other words, you don't need to use the external terminal window. You can use it directly integrated into the environment in which you are working, in the case of NetBeans. In this part, we have looked at the Oracle Jet command line interface. You have seen how easy it is to set up, and also you have used it to create new Oracle Jet applications, while you have seen a range of facilities that the command line interface provides as well, such as the ability to strip and restore libraries from your application. For your homework exercise, go back to oraclejet.org, go to the Get Started page, which you can get to from the main navigation bar or from the front page, and use the OJET tool to create the different templates that Oracle Jet makes available. So with the OJET command line interface set up, don't only create the nav drawer template as you have been doing throughout this course, but also use the nav bar template and the basic template and the blank template. Compare them to each other, open them in the browser and see what the differences are. Look at the source code and try and understand why there are four different templates and what differences they provide and in which contexts each of them might be useful. As always, thank you for taking part in the Oracle Jet course, and we look forward to seeing you in the next part.